you, Matia?
Good, thank you.
So we're here at the Mercedes-Benz plant in South Carolina, which this has been here for 10 years. You have a big announcement yesterday just next door here, right?
Yeah, that's true. We are very proud of that. We had our groundbreaking yesterday, finally, for our real factory here in Ladson, to make sure that we don't only sell the great Sprinter here in the US, but that we also produce it here in the US. So we had the big groundbreaking yesterday, and in the next years we will build a real factory here. Currently it's only a reassembling of the vans we ship from Germany, but it will be a real parts by parts factory in the near future.
Can you take maybe a minute to explain that crazy law that exists, and that's the reason that you have the current operation here?
I think the best thing to mention first, it applies to all manufacturers, not only to Mercedes-Benz.
But still it's crazy.
It's still crazy. It's called the chicken tax, which basically means if you want to import a cargo van from outside of the US to the US, there is a certain amount, 25% in tolls charged for that. And to avoid that, what we do is basically we build the Sprinter in Düsseldorf in Germany. Immediately afterwards, we disassemble it in various parts.
Perfect finished product?
Yeah, the perfectly finished product, the quality approved product. We disassemble once again. We put it on different vessels, ship it to the US, bring it here to the factory in Ladson, ship it and merge the components again here in this factory, do a new quality check, and then sell it here in the US. And this is why we finally said we have so great sales numbers here in the US, we have to have our own factory here, a part-by-part factory, being closer to our, meanwhile, second biggest market worldwide for the Sprinter.
So even though with that complicated process that I heard Bernie Iglesias, the head of sales, he's like, call it like a nightmare process.
I think
you're still successful with that.
Yeah, we're still successful, and as I said, the only thing you can avoid it is having your own factory here. And that it applies to all vans. It's a pretty complicated process, but it still makes more sense than paying 25%. And but of course, the time to market is an issue, and this is why it makes a lot of sense really producing right here in the US.
So the production will start, I understand, at the end of the decade, right?
End
so
of,
still a few
decade,
years
yeah.
of this.
Yeah. So what you see outside is currently not a building yet, but that will change pretty soon. And over the next years, we will build the real factory, parts by parts factory. All the suppliers will come to this region, and we'll step by step then be able to offer it right out of this factory.
So and now you've been building the Sprinter for 10 years, and since October, I think, this one, the Matrix, right?
That's true, yeah. And the Matrix we just launched to the market last year, our new mid-size van, the segment doesn't exist in the US currently. It did in the past, in the 90s, with the Astro van, very successful segment. And we decided that we think the Matrix has exactly the right size for this market, much better than a small van. Capabilities comparable to small or large vans, but a very, very nice and handy footprint. And this is why we think the Matrix has the right size for this market.
So even as just a few months, it's 8 months since it's debuted here in the States, you already announced it like second version, the Matrix Worker here that we have seen here?
That's true. We launched it in October last year. October, November, the first vehicles really got shipped to customers. And now after 1 year, we do what we already started with the Sprinter. We offer the so-called Worker line. Worker line for us means we want to make sure that we can address all the customers of vans. And that's why we started doing that with the Sprinter Worker and why we do it with the Matrix Worker now as well. We had a lot of customers approaching us, telling us we really love driving a Matrix or driving a Sprinter, but we want to have a streamlined offer. We don't need too many fancy options or whatever. We just want to have it streamlined. We are plumbers, I'm a painter, I'm
basic
a florist.
We
just want to have a basic vehicle
use, yeah.
for a good price with all your safety and reliability you bring with your product, with the handling of it. And then we decided, okay, we'll do the same. We'll expand our Worker family, and with offering the Matrix Worker as a cargo van and as a passenger van, we have the huge chance of now offering it for $25,995, which is extremely competitive, which is pretty close to the small vans, but on the other hand, the capabilities are rather comparable to the large vans.
Yeah. So $25,995 for a Mercedes-Benz, that's pretty good.
It's pretty aggressive.
Yeah. So commercial vehicles from Mercedes-Benz are very successful outside the US, or have been for decades. Here in the States, we know more Mercedes-Benz for luxury, sports cars, and SUVs and all that. But I think that having that notion from the people, from the customers, with that kind of thinking of luxury, this also helps selling a Mercedes-Benz commercial vehicle.
That's true. I mean, we have a completely different situation here than to Europe. Daimler, so our company, is the world's largest manufacturer for commercial vehicles. Many people know that, but that's the case. But we have different brands, and here in the US we are very strong with Freightliner, which belongs to our company, Western Star, etc. So a lot of brands, but we don't have Mercedes-Benz trucks here in the US. So customers only see, as you said, very nice convertibles, etc. With a star, but what they're not used to is seeing commercial vehicles with a star. In Europe, for decades, people have seen Mercedes-Benz trucks with a huge star on the hood. And so they're used to it, and they know that Mercedes-Benz stands for, especially for cost efficiency when it comes to offering commercial vehicles. But here in the US, that's indeed a challenge, and that changes now, but it's indeed a challenge in getting rid of this price perception. Someone sees a star, everyone thinks, oh, will be an extremely expensive product, but now we have to overcome that because it is as affordable as another van, but it brings all the great benefits of owning a Mercedes-Benz.
So heavy-duty work, commercial, many, many different uses. Here we are at the plant and we see like at least 20 different variants, like from an ambulance, a pet grooming car, everything. So I'm going to tell you my little Mercedes-Benz joke about the logo, because I know it officially, we build engines for the ocean, for the land, and for the sky, right?
Right.
There's a version I heard somewhere, I don't know where, and it's a work schedule. I come in at 8, I go to lunch at noon, I go home at 4.
I think that's not true for everyone.
For neither. No, exactly. But this, you can work much more hours than that.
And I think this is the feedback we get from customers. We can talk a lot about cost efficiency, where we are really bad for. We can talk a lot about safety. But what we really want to make sure and is to get the customers in the van, make them drive the van, and I think they figure out the huge difference to other products themselves.
Yeah, hopefully you work more than 8 hours.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.